Good morning, happy Monday. This is my breakfast, my first meal of the day post-workout. I have one slice of gluten-free bread with some jelly on top. I have some kimchi. Probiotics really helps great with digestion, helps to keep your face nice and clear. And then two whole eggs for some protein and healthy fats. And I'm gonna eat this, and then I will talk to you in a little bit for what I did this morning in regards to pre-workout nutrition and what I did right after my workout. But this is my very first meal, and it is 10:35 in the morning on Monday, March 4th. What I do on a daily basis, nutrition and supplement wise. So first thing in the morning, I wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning and I take a fitness workout class at either 7:30 or 8 o'clock, depending on which one I go to. Bend down, I don't have a tripod, so I'm just like having to make it work. So I wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning, and today I did a workout at 7:30 in the morning, and I go to my workout fasted. So the reason I do that is because I like to eat a little bit later on at nighttime. I actually don't like going to my workouts fasted. I would rather have something to eat, but the workout classes that I do are very, very intense, especially the one I did today. It's called Drip Fit. It's been featured on my story before, on my YouTube before. It's like really crazy sprinting on these special treadmills, and then you weight lift as well. And when I eat too close to that workout, I don't feel good because I have the food in my stomach. I don't have enough time to digest. So I'm actually going to make some like energy bites today, which I will show you, of course, a little bit later. They're gonna be all natural little energy bites, little tiny things that I can just pop in the morning. So I'll show you that today. But this morning I did do a fasted workout. I eat a little bit later on at nighttime, so my last meal will fuel me for my early morning workout. But right after my workout, immediately after my workout, I have a protein shake of the 1UP ISO protein. It's the whey protein isolate, best quality, fast digesting protein that you can get. And then I also, which I just started doing, I just got this stuff in the mail, so I'm super excited to show you. They're tri-carb. It's three different carb sources that I put with my protein shake here, and it's unflavored, so it doesn't have a terrible taste at all. I've had some carb drinks that taste absolutely horrible, and this is 100% unflavored, and it's just getting the glycogen back to replenish my muscles, because the glycogen kind of, when you work out, it depletes, and I want to refill that in my body so my muscles can kind of get fed. It's like the food for my muscles right after a really intense workout. So I have a shake. It is 25 grams of carbs and 25 grams of protein. Zero fat. So I drink that like on my way home, and then I come home and I shower, I put myself together, and then I eat my first real meal about an hour and a half after my workout. So this morning I just did, like you saw, two eggs because I wanted the protein, but I also wanted some healthy fats because so far today I have only had protein and carbs. So instead of egg whites, I did two whole eggs, kimchi just for digestion, probiotics. I'm trying to get kimchi in two meals a day, whether that's even just like snacking on it throughout the day, but I'm trying to do two meals with kimchi just for that probiotic support. And then my gluten-free toast with a little bit of jelly just for those extra carbs. And the gluten-free toast has fiber, so it's gonna keep me full. And a meal like that, this here, a meal like that is pretty low volume for me. am a hungry person, as you guys know. So just two eggs and a slice of toast and some kimchi. You know, old Christina would have been like, that's not enough food. I need a whole bowl of stuff. But I'm telling you, water. Chug water after you eat. You saw me chugging that water right after I took my last bite of bread. I am so full right now. It's insane how full I am after drinking water. And if I didn't drink water, I would have thought I was hungry, but I wasn't hungry. So I drink as much water as I can. I drank this whole thing so far right after I ate. And then I also took the supplements that I showed you. I take two fish oil tablets, zinc, because I am deficient in zinc, and then the Alani Nutrition Balance. I have been taking this for the past couple months. I'm on a subscription. This is not sponsored at all. It's just for hormonal balance, supports complexion and fertility. I really did it just because I wanted to make sure my hormones were good after I competed, and then also for my skin. I saw on Instagram a lot of people were saying that this has totally changed their skin and their breakouts, and I would say yeah. I can't remember what my skin was like when I first started taking it, but I don't really break out. So I would recommend trying this if you wanna get your hormones, just make sure your hormones are in check, and then also for your skin acne. And you saw me taking my L-carnitine with my breakfast. I take a liquid L-carnitine from 1UP Nutrition. I just take a capful. I take that with my post-workout meal. It is really great pre and post-workout. I like to take this, especially when I'm not taking my fat burning pre-workout. So my fat burning pre-workout already has L-carnitine in it because it's fat burning. And what L-carnitine is, it is a non-stimulant, so no caffeine, fat burner. It uses your fat for energy. So you will burn fat for energy during your workouts. So when I take this pre-workout, this is the fat burning pre-workout, I do not take this pre-workout. I do not. But early in the morning, especially for the class that I went to today, where it's very high intensity interval training cardio focus, I actually don't take this pre-workout. I take my sport aminos because this is all my amino acids, so all my BCAAs, and I need that because I am fasted, and then it also has a little bit of caffeine because I do have coffee in the morning, so I don't need, and this has a lot of caffeine, so I don't need that much caffeine. So with my early morning cardio focused workouts, I always take sport amino. There is no fat burning ingredients in here, so I stack this when I'm doing early morning a cardio type of workout. And so that's my little spiel on my nutrition, my current nutrition and my supplements right now. And then I wanna show you really quick what I did this morning. You can see. So I have some chicken in my crock pot, just two chicken breasts. It's really just for me. And then of course this morning when Brian saw what I was making, he usually does not like shredded chicken in the crock pot. So I didn't think to make it for him because he never likes my salsa chicken. He never likes it, never eats it. So I just made two breasts for me. And this week for my lunches, I will be making kind of like a shredded chicken Asian bowl. I'll show it to you today. I'll show you what my lunch looks like today. But this is for my lunch. I started this at 6 o'clock this morning and I put it on high for 8 hours. And so it'll be ready just about around noon. And what I did was I added probably like maybe like a third of a cup of water. And then I added my chicken and I seasoned it with garlic salt, garlic powder, and this umami seasoning from Trader Joe's. It is a mushroom umami. It's really, really good. I'm thinking like the Asian flavor. So I just did this, this, and garlic salt. I seasoned the chicken with that, and then after I seasoned the chicken, I just poured some of this stir fry sauce all over the top of it, and the macros are pretty damn good. Three carbs, but it is for one tablespoon, and I just opened this, so I used about half of this container, but when you are, see how the chicken, it's not like drenched in the sauce. The sauce really is just to give it some liquid so the chicken can shred. So it's not, I'm not gonna have too many carbs from this sauce actually on the chicken when I go to eat it. But what it's doing is it just gives it enough liquid so it can shred, and it's also flavoring it. So I will be having this chicken. I did it this morning. So I will show you guys my lunch. little update on my skin. I feel like it's like purging a little bit. Like my skin is almost getting worse right now, but I know that that is expected. But it just feels really clean. I mean, I still have spots. I got this done last Thursday at 5 p.m. and it is Monday morning. So it hasn't been a week yet. I still am recovering and my skin is purging and kind of scabbing a little bit. My skin feels kind of rough in texture, but I am gonna be keeping my makeup off and making sure that I am super moisturized and just really prioritizing water and all of that. So what today looks like for me, just to give you guys a little, I don't know, update about what I'm doing today. Right now, it is March 4th, Monday, and I'm gonna go take a walk really quick. I love to take a walk before I start any work because I do sit for quite some time. I sit for hours at a time, so I like to just get moving, especially after I eat. And the first order of business today is going to be, I'm gonna be planning out my month of March in my little, I have a little journal notebook thing. And I'm just gonna be planning out my month of March, what I want it to look like in my business, kind of goals setting, just the type of influencer and coach I want to show up as this month. And I really am gonna start doing this once a month. At the beginning of every month, I'm going to set intentions and goals for the month ahead. And then at the end of the month, I'm gonna go back and kind of like review how my month went, and then all throughout the month I will be checking in with myself and holding myself accountable and making sure that I am showing up in the way that I intended at the beginning of month, at the month. And besides that, if you just like the kind of like the back end stuff of my business that no one really sees, I have two calls today with two of my business coaching clients. I'm gonna talk, one of the girls just started with me, so we're gonna really work on her ideal client, the type of coach she wants to become, give her my secret tips and tricks on how to start landing clients as soon as possible, and really just teaching her how to speak and show up on social media so she can portray the type of coach that she wants to be to her following. And then with my other client, she has been with me for about a month now, and I'm gonna talk to her just about growth and helping her plan her month in a very strategic way. And then other than those two calls, I just have client check-ins, and I'm going to be working on some email list content because I really want, a goal of mine this month of March is to put out consistent emails for you, the people who are signed up for my email list campaigns. So just a bunch of free content, free updates from me, recipes, workouts, motivation, that kind of thing. So that's what I'm doing today, and I will catch you guys probably for lunch, my little Asian bowl, and then stay tuned. Don't click out of the video because you're not gonna wanna miss my healthy energy bites, which is going to be either a snack at the end of the night, a little sweet tooth snack, or a perfect pre-workout grab and go protein, fats, and carbs, all super healthy, really clean, amazing pre-workout. So stay tuned to the end of the video for that recipe. I'll check you guys later.
Anything happened? Like, what got me the results that the month got me? Right? I wrote about like the experiences that I had to really solidify that this month just happened, like all these beautiful things happened, and really expressing gratitude for this.
Exactly, yes. And I'm also going to send you my templates as well. I didn't want to overload you that first week with all the stuff. So I'm gonna send you actually templates I have, because I also want you to be able to be 100% set up on the back end of your business of like, okay, how am I gonna even write, like send people these workouts? So what I have is I have the way that I write my workouts, and I send you like that blank template, but we'll talk about that. You know, I think this week, the most important thing is like the packages, the application, you know, your update form and the questionnaire as well. Cause when someone signs on, you wanna, you know, learn about them. You know, what are they doing now? Are they tracking macros? What are their macros? What's their height and their weight? So that's the most important thing.
Oh my gosh, look at this chicken. It looks so good. So I told you I only did about 1/4 of a cup to 1/3 of a cup of water. with that stir fry seasoning or stir fry sauce, and I'm so happy I didn't do too much water because I don't want it watery, you know? Like I just stirred up the chicken all in the sauce, and so it is so flavorful. Oh my gosh. So I'm just gonna put together a little bowl of butter lettuce, some Japanese sweet potatoes, going with the theme of Asian, and then these are some veggies that I meal prepped last night on the grill. It is eggplant, zucchini, and bell pepper, and then I'm also gonna add my kimchi, and then I might drizzle some of this almond butter turmeric salad dressing over the top. I don't know why it's not focusing. So that's gonna be lunch. My little breakfast protein energy balls. These are gonna be so good and so perfect. First thing in the morning, right before my workout. I am so excited to have these tomorrow pre-workout to see how it changes from me working out fasted with nothing in my stomach and then having one of these with all of these all natural ingredients. I mean, I'm not using any artificial sweetener. I'm using all natural, really good ingredients because I want natural energy. I don't want a low calorie treat that is filled with artificial junk. I want natural energy. That is why I use the maple syrup, I use the cashew butter, I use the almond flour, I use the oats. I could have used Walden Farms, okay? So like if you did want to make this a lot less carb, I would substitute the maple syrup for Walden Farms syrup, but that is loaded with fake chemicals. Like it's not, I mean, if you're trying to hit your macros, if you're on prep, if you're on a weight loss journey, like yes, I would do the Walden Farms if you need to, but if you care about the quality of food, I would highly recommend using a maple syrup. Now, I found this. I just wanted to point this out really quick. I got this at Trader Joe's. It is a maple syrup and agave blend, and it actually is a lot less carbs than either honey or just maple syrup, because you can also use honey in this recipe as well, just anything sticky and sweet for to make it, to, you know, obviously to sweeten it. I did want to go for like the lowest calorie option while still keeping it very like 100% natural, and the only ingredients in this is organic cane sugar, organic maple syrup, organic agave syrup, and this was less calories. So if you do have a Trader Joe's around you, I would try to find this. So I made 15 of them. I'm just gonna keep them in the fridge. They're gonna be perfect pre-workout. Let me know if you guys tried this recipe, and I will see you guys in the next vlog. Please subscribe if you like my videos. Please like this video if you enjoyed the content, the recipes, and then comment below just with any love, any feedback. Let me know if you're gonna make these. And I did try them. I didn't try a ball yet. I just tried the batter as I was making it. And this protein, adding in the cinnamon toast crunch, or what is it? Cinnamon French toast. It gives it such a great flavor, and it makes them just like thick. And I love 1UP Nutrition protein, so I can't recommend this protein enough. I'm excited about this recipe. Let me know if you make it. Show me some love, and I will see you guys in a couple days for my next vlog.